No, for God's sake. The opener of episode 10 is Ah Sahm, featured in this huge mural. I think the funny part for My Ling is, of course he gets noticed. Of course he gets all this gratitude.
Everyone was going, oh, this is so cool. You see a mural of yourself on the wall? I thought it was funny. I think my nose is too big.
When I read that Andrew Koji was going to be painted on a mural, I laughed because that's just not Andrew Koji's style, which is why he's perfect to play Ah Sahm, because it's not Ah Sahm's style either. And I think that's what I love about the show is, like, even in the darkest moments, we find moments of humor and levity.
The mural was just something that came together in the writer's room, this idea that a folk hero would be born out of the ashes of a riot, that folk hero would be Ah Sahm, and that it would cause even greater divisions among his allies. Seeing Ah Sahm celebrated angers Youngjun, it annoys My Ling, and it excites Ah Toy.
It's an opportunity. You're a symbol to your people.
Ah Toy was always one of the people who saw the true promise that Ah Sahm had. And the fact that the people of Chinatown celebrated him proves Ah Toy right.
What the fuck is this?
I can't do it anymore.
I think the thing that really pushes Lee over the edge is the complete loss of control during the riot.
We're not meant to succeed, Bill. We're just bagging flyers for politicians while they count their votes.
And knowing how far things have gone with Bill, there's a certain level of acceptance to knowing what Bill is. And I think he's just not willing to fight anymore to try and help Bill redeem himself.
I haven't known you for very long, but I do know that you're better than this.
When Lee resigns, Bill is devastated. He's not just losing a friend, he's not just losing a professional asset. He also feels responsible. So Lee leaving Bill is, it's the last straw.
We can't afford to be fighting amongst each other.
You mean you can't afford it?
I just don't want to be at war with my own brother anymore.
What? What brother?
That was such a fun scene. There's so much tension when that bomb drops.
What the hell was that?
A last resort. When Leon kind of gives her hell about, like, well, you could have warned me. It's true, it's like, I had no idea I was gonna do that. It just so happened that he's pushing and he keeps pushing back Youngjun, and so I'm just gonna put him in his place.
My Ling aside, she's just got one more card to play, which is to separate Ah Sahm and Youngjun.
Here's what I think. I think you've been lying to me since the day you got here.
To find out that Ah Sahm is the sibling of her most hated rival is something that really sends him for a tailspin.
You didn't throw that tournament. I know what I saw. We've been through too much for me to believe you have any loyalty to her.
There are certain things that don't add up, but when he does the math, he realizes that he is loyal. His actions do not speak of someone who has been double-crossing. That being said, there's enough distrust that, although I forgive him, there's still lingering doubt.
But when the time comes, and it's her or me, are you gonna make the right choice?
Mrs. Blake, I'm so sorry for your loss. What happened was just awful.
You don't actually know what happened. Nobody does, except me. I'm talking about an exclusive.
When Penny went and sold the story, she thinks she's cleared Jacob's name. When she finds out that the reporter had been bought, she's so pissed off.
You bastard! So you're buying reporters now?
The final straw is when she touches him in such a violent way. He calculates what he needs to do, and he does it.
When Buckley picks up that letter opener, everyone should be sure he's going to attack Penny, but he wants her out of the way, and he finds a way to punish her for going up against them.
So I read that, and I was like, what? Like, are you, what?
Help! She stabbed me!
Come on home with us.
She stabbed me!
He stabbed himself! When that era, a man with one word could have a woman committed. This means so much to her that she can come across like she's losing it. So that when she's committed, everyone's like, oh yeah, that makes sense.
And now the question is she gonna be able to sort of emerge from this more powerful, or is she gonna emerge from this deranged?
What happens now?
I'm thinking I'm gonna kick your Irish ass in front of all your buddies here.
We knew the season was going to end with Ah Sahm and Leary fighting each other. There's really a lot of understanding between them, and they're kind of fighting the same fight, and that's why it became really fascinating to actually pit them against each other.
So it was a hard shoot. It was 3 days of night shooting and trying to find these different moments, trying to go outside the choreography a bit, play with this, play with that, do this and do that. And so technically, it was very difficult.
Oh, Leary doesn't fight like a boxer. He's got his own style. When he's coming at you like a train.
It's a gentleman's brawl. It's like, okay, you're the alpha male of the pack, I'm the alpha male of my pack. Let's fucking do this.
Stay out of Chinatown, or I'll be back with a fucking army.
I love shooting it this season. Everything really seemed to come together.
It's pretty amazing the way we've expanded the show. I think it opens up a whole other era of Chinese American history.
This is what I love about the show. They have really smashed these characters together in this world.
From the very beginning, I was immediately pulled into it.
Everyone's stories descend further into the difficulty of living in Chinatown at the time.
I think the resiliency was what was amazing about the Chinese community in San Francisco at this time. With all of the riots, with all the anger towards them, they bounced back and they rebuilt.
It feels authentic to our time and the issues that we're still wrestling with.
When you're telling an immigration story, it's always going to be about the family you have and the family you find.
It's very much Bruce Lee's story, coming together. Everybody did amazing, passionate about the show, and really loved their characters.
Mai Ling was such a fun character to play. Just her trying to stand her ground as a woman in power.
It's a really beautiful, well-made show full of passion, made by passionate people.
It's exciting, different, and I think the way we wrote it and the way it was shot came out really beautifully.
I'm not gonna say I was blown away by it. To see it all together like that, phenomenal.
I felt like this season paid tribute to the legend that Bruce Lee became in the way which feels organic to the story. It was amazing.
Hey, thanks for watching. Did you know that the greatest rivalry in Kung Fu is not between any hero and villain, or even between two popular actors, but between two studios, Shaw Brothers and Golden Harvest? Golden Harvest was founded by former employees of Shaw Brothers, which surely adds to the rivalry. The two studios are responsible for virtually all of the best-loved Kung Fu films. Do you like my shirt? You can get one for yourself in the link in the description.